Hi, this is Dan Brunton with the Intel Corporation, and I'll be giving you an overview of changes made in the last few versions of Intel Endpoint Management Assistant. It's been a little while since I've done one of these. I have to play a little bit of catch-up, so today we'll be talking about changes introduced in Intel EMA 1.9.0, 1.10.0, and 1.11.0, our latest version. There's been a lot that's happened, but I'm going to focus on some specific areas. We'll talk about Azure Active Directory support, a new user interface for our alarm clock function for waking up PCs, Granular Access Controls. We'll also talk about some things that have changed on the development side of things, including a new server info API that we have, and a new client credential authorization type used for administrative functions in Intel EMA. With that, let's go ahead and get started. Let's start with Azure Active Directory support, introduced in Intel EMA 1.9.0. Intel EMA now supports Azure Active Directory authentication for the Intel EMA web interface. Support for more capabilities, like Azure Active Directory groups, will come in later versions of Intel EMA. If you are setting up a new install of Intel EMA, you'll see Azure Active Directory authentication as one of the options available during installation. If you have an existing installation of Intel EMA using on-prem Active Directory authentication, you can migrate to Azure Active Directory authentication through an option in the installer. Next, I'd like to show you the new interface for managing alarm clock, also introduced in Intel EMA 1.9.0. It's accessed from the Actions menu, and you can have up to 5 separate wake timers set per device. Granular access controls have been a frequently requested feature and are included with Intel EMA 1.11.0. Previously, you could assign anyone with the Endpoint Group Creator or Endpoint Group User role to access specific endpoint groups. Now, you can further limit access to specific use cases. This lets you ensure that the right people have just the right access. Our server info API, introduced in Intel EMA 1.10.0, is designed to make it easier for developers to understand the capabilities of an Intel EMA instance. You don't need to authenticate to use this API, and it will show you the Intel EMA version, API support details, and authentication model used by the server. I'll finish with our new Client Credentials type, also introduced in Intel EMA 1.10.0. Before this change, you could only use the Client Credentials for management use cases. Intel EMA 1.10.0 added a new scope option to create a Client Credential that allows tenant administrative functions, such as managing users or endpoint groups. You can learn more about these changes I mentioned here and others in the release notes, published with the Intel EMA download package. Thank you for watching.